In the next question, input-output relationship of a system is given, and we have to check these properties. Now, if we will apply law of superposition in this relationship, then it will follow law of additivity, homogeneity, and in this system follows law of homogeneity, law of additivity. So this system is following law of superposition, and this system follows law of superposition, so the given system is linear. Now, for causality of system, in case of causal system, output will be independent of future values of input. Suppose if we will put time instant n equals to 2, then y of 2 will be equal to summation 0 to 4 cos pi by 4k into x of k. So if we have to calculate output at n equals to 2 second, then we have to use value of input up to n equals to 4 second. For 2 second, for output at 2 second, this 4 second input is a future value. So for y of 2, x of 4 is a future value of input. And if the system depends on future values of input, then system will not be causal. So the given system is a non-causal system, because in this system output depends on future values of input. Now, in case of time invariance, if we will go through the block diagram for time invariance to check time invariance of a system, then it will be like this. First of all, we will apply input xn, and we will obtain system output yn. Now, then we will apply a delay of constant delay to the output yn. Suppose we are applying a delay of 1 second, then output will be equal to y of n minus 1. Now we will interchange these two blocks, and we will apply delay of 1 second here. So output of delay block will be x of n minus 1. Now then we will apply this delayed input to the given system. Suppose if we are getting output y dash n, if these two terms are equal, then system will be time invariant. But in this case, what will happen, if we will check, then yn will be equal to summation 0 to n square cos pi by 4k into x of k. Now, we have to write down y of n minus 1. So y of n minus 1. So in this function, we have to replace variable n with new variable n minus 1. So it will be like this, 0 to n minus 1 whole square cos pi by 4k into x of k. Now, in the lower path, system input is x of n minus 1. And if we are going to apply this input to the given system, then output y dash will be equal to summation 0 to n square cos pi by 4k into x of k minus 1 into x of k minus 1. Now, if we will check, then these two terms, y of n minus 1 and y dash n, these two terms are unequal. And if output of upper path and output of this lower path are different, then system will be time variant. So the given system is time variant. Now, to check stability of system, we will proceed in this way. We will use BIBO criteria. So for stability of system we will use bounded input, bounded output criteria. So we are going to apply any bounded input which is bounded in amplitude. And behavioral criteria says that if input to any system is bounded in amplitude and output of system is also bounded in amplitude, then system will be stable. So we are going to apply here cos pi by 4 n. This term is bounded in amplitude, so this term is bounded signal. Now for this term we will obtain output as summation 0 to n square cos square pi by 4 k. So we can write down this term in this way, summation 0 to n square 1 plus cos pi by 2 k divided by 2. Now we can write down first term in this way, summation 1 by 2 range 0 to n square plus some finite part cos pi by 2k divided by 2. If we are going to put k as an integer, then whatever this term, summation of this term will produce a bounded result, but summation of this term will become unbounded. Summation of this term will become unbounded because if n will be infinite here, then we have to add infinite number of times 1 by 2 with itself. So first part of this signal will become unbounded and we are applying bounded input. So this system is violating the criteria of bounded input, bounded output. So the given system will be unstable. If we will look at all four options, then option D will satisfy this result.